Hey guys, a little intro before the intro here. This video that I'm uploading today was actually the video I uploaded yesterday. It's the video about Holly Brown. And YouTube blocked it because I had a little clip from a newscast in there. If you guys watched it, you probably know what I'm talking about. It was just a tiny little clip about something I was talking about, and it didn't even have any sound. I don't even know how YouTube found it, but they were on it like, you know, white on rice. And the police state that is YouTube, they blocked the content. They stopped it from getting out there on YouTube and, you know, saved your guys' eyes from the horribleness of copyright infringement. So anyway, here's the video. I took the newscast clip out so you guys are safe. If you got here early yesterday, you might have already seen this video. And if you didn't, then here you go. This is it. Enjoy the video. Hey guys, it's Jeff Lafferty. It's Artcast 537. I'm just sitting here doing some sketches. A lot of these little sketches in the front of the Berserkonaut. There's one of them. Let's see. There's another. Right there. Just endless. You're never going to end. Actually, they're getting kind of close. I think I'm down to like 15 more. And then I'll be done with that. But anyway, let's get going. Let's draw another sketch. Did you guys see the video that Holly Brown made like a few days ago talking about possibly deleting her channel and, you know, leaving YouTube or starting over on YouTube in some other place? I'm not quite exactly sure what the plan was beyond deleting either a lot of videos or her channel. And I was just kind of shocked. I was very shocked because, you know, Holly Brown, I don't know if you guys know who she is. She's like a big YouTuber now. And she started, you know, kind of around the same time I did. And I remember when, you know, our channels were like similar size, you know, like I had, you know, like 7,000 subscribers and she had like, you know, 9,000 or something. And she was just cruising along with all of us, like me and Scott and like Kevin Cross and everybody that was making videos back then. And like all of a sudden, man, she just started ramping up, you know. And one day I went over to her channel to kind of see what she was doing, and she was like at 70,000 subscribers. I was like, what the fuck? When did this happen, you know? And it just kept going from there. And so like when I was over there before, I can't remember exactly how many she has, but she's got like over 200,000 at this point. So like I would say she's definitely a successful YouTuber. And anyway, this whole video is kind of about, it sounded a little bit like kind of mental anguish from being trolled on YouTube. And I don't know if she brought it on herself. You know, the way she kind of talked, maybe she is kind of looking at it like that. I know that people have actually come and commented on my channel about her sometimes. Like I interviewed her one time a long time ago, just kind of trying to figure out like how she's being so successful on YouTube. And there was like some, you know, there's just been comments I've had to delete off that video that have just been kind of derogatory. And I don't usually leave those kinds of comments up. I just delete them. But I was just really surprised, you know, just what she was saying about just sort of not liking the controversy or just sort of the criticism on her channel. And I don't blame her, you know. It's like my channel's still small compared to hers, you know, even though it's bigger than what it was, you know, before. And I still don't like the criticism I got in my channel. If I was getting like, you know, 200 comments and half of them were like telling me I suck every day, that shit would get old after a while, you know. And I don't know, it just kind of got me thinking about this this other video I watched a while ago. Maybe I'll even try to find this and cut this in, but it was really interesting. It was like about basically about kids that get trolled on the internet, you know, get bullied at school, and then they get trolled on the internet by the bullies, you know, like as if it isn't bad enough they got to put up with these assholes at school. They fucking find them on the internet and then they fucking, you know, bother them there too. And you know, it was about like these two kids that killed themselves over it. It's just really, really sad. And then in the middle of this, they had a video of this one father that he kind of goes down to this, like, this, it looks like a park, and he confronts this little smart ass that's been like bullying his daughter. And the kid smarts off to him, and the guy just goes after him and starts hammering on him. And it's pretty funny, at least from my perspective. I'm sure a lot of people would look at that and think that's just completely out of line, you know, some 40-year-old guy punching out some like 16-year-old kid. But I don't know, you know, it's like the kid kind of made his bed, and in my opinion, kind of got what he was asking for. And anyway, you know, the sad part about this whole thing was the kids that actually killed themselves. And, you know, the parents going like, well, I didn't fucking realize, you know, I didn't realize this shit was happening. And, you know, it's like you wouldn't know as a parent. You don't know what your kid's reading online or looking at on the internet, and you don't know what's happening to them at school either. You know, you really, really don't. My parents didn't know what was happening to me at school. And I got bullied a little, not as bad as some people for sure. When I was in school, I used to get into a lot of fights when I was in school. So that was kind of my answer to it. And I definitely didn't win them all, that's for sure. But you know, with the internet, there isn't none of that though. You know, the bullies just get away bullying, and they never get the consequences because they're anonymous. They're out there in the anonymous, you know, internet sphere, and they can just be dicks and never pay for what they've done. Not physically, anyway. I mean, nobody can go and get them and, you know, make them stop. They might feel guilt at some point. They might feel guilty about what they do if they're human. But I don't know. In like Holly's case, I wonder if like they're thinking about that, because I think, but yeah, I don't know. You know, the internet's very much like high school. You know, it's like, these cliques of kids get together and they pick on the single kid by himself because they can get away with it because they have the power of the numbers. It's the same thing with YouTube, you know, and especially like when you get into these bigger YouTubers, especially when they go at it, you know, when they start fighting, you know, kind of like this stuff with Ethan Van Sciver fighting against some of the comic skate guys that are smaller. I don't know if you guys have been paying attention to any of that, but it's sort of like whoever's got the biggest audience, they can send towards the other person kind of wins because their noise drowns out the other person's noise. And it just kind of sucks, you know, because it's sort of like might makes right. And that kind of law was sort of like, you know, that's like caveman law, you know, that's not the laws of like civilization. You know, everybody gets to have a say now, you know. My thoughts are, I really hope that she doesn't actually delete her channel. Because, like, you know, 200 and something thousand viewers or subscribers, I mean, you know, she's really headed towards, you know, like a Bailey J or a Draw with Jazza or Proko or something. Is that his name, Proko? Tristan watches a cartoon called Proko. And I wonder if that's actually what I'm thinking about. But the guy that has a similar name is Proko. I can't remember his name. You know, but I mean, she's like headed towards like those massive art channels that have like a couple million viewers, and then who knows where you go from there, you know? That's opportunity. And you know, the thing is she did it on her own back, you know what I mean? She freaking did it on her own back. Because like she started like at the same place like I am, you know what I mean? And she somehow fucking climbed a mountain when I couldn't figure out my way up there, you know? I mean, she just did it doing her videos and doing her stuff and just sort of putting out her real self, you know? She didn't sort of like, you know, be like these big mouths that are like, you know, just be like me or put out tutorials or like that are always sort of giving you the roadmap to success, you know? It's like she didn't do any of that shit. You know, she just put her content out there and got there on her own steam, on her own back, you know what I mean? She didn't fucking, like, you know, preach the gospel of keywords and then somehow make it up the ladder, you know. She really actually made it up the YouTube ladder, and that's a fucking tough ladder to climb. So anyway, she has my respect for sure. I don't care like what she says. I don't care if people like her or dislike her. I personally think that was an amazing feat to get where she's at, and I hope that she can look at that for what it is and actually be proud of what she did. And I remember one time we were actually on a live stream. I think it was me and Kevin and Scott, maybe after the show of maybe after the live Artcaster show. And I don't think Scott was, or no, I don't think Kevin was in there. But it might have been when kind of Kevin took a break from the show, and it was like just me and Scott all the time. Anyway, she was in there talking, and I was talking to her. And I remember telling her, you know, I think we were just talking about trolls. Because, I mean, you know, if you're on YouTube, you got trolled. You know, that's just the way it is, you know. At some point, somebody's going to start fucking with you. And I remember I had a tough time with that in the beginning. You know, I wasn't used to people sort of like going out of their way to fuck with me, you know. Going out of their way to like shut my store down, or going out of their way to like just screw up my stuff for no reason. Just because they didn't like me or whatever. And I was kind of talking about the comments. I would get, you know, you get bad comments sometimes. And I was telling her that, you know, I got to delete them. I can't leave them there. I got to delete them. You know, I don't respond to them anymore, because that just leads to big fights. But I do have to delete them, because I just can't deal with them being there. Nowadays, I don't really have to delete them. I actually kind of just don't care. You know what I mean? It's just like, I just don't even have the energy to sort of get mad at them anymore, you know? But anyway, this has kind of got to do with what she said, because she said, you know, she was talking about being trolled on her channel, and she's like, I just laugh at them. And I just thought, whoa, that's tough, you know what I mean? It's one tough chick that can just laugh that shit off, you know? And I think that by not caring, that's sort of my version of just laughing them off, you know? But I've always kind of felt like that was sort of some advice she gave me that I followed. That's actually really helped me just dealing with people in general on YouTube. Because you do get fucking stupid comments that you want to get on and just go like, you know, blah, you know, just type like mad and just tear this guy a new asshole. But more often than not, you know, those really stupid comments and shit like that, they're coming from people that are like, you know, they're either 12 years old in their fucking room, you know, just firing off some insult at you. Or they're like a guy that's like 40 years old that has like the mental, you know, the mentality of a 12-year-old. If somebody like that said something to you in a grocery store, you wouldn't just tear into that person. You'd just be like, okay, he's got problems. I'll just go about my business. You know what I mean? But anyway, you know, back to Holly, though. I just hope she sticks it out and doesn't go away. And I also hope she doesn't feel bad about anything that she's done. Because, you know, even if you just got to cut the comments off your channel, I mean, you've got such a huge channel, you could just turn your comments off for a while. It wouldn't affect anything, you know. But anyway, I wish her luck with, you know, whatever she does, you know, moving forward from here and that. So, yeah. So that's it, guys. I'll see you guys probably not tomorrow, because, you know, Thanksgiving and all that stuff's coming. Anyway, mailing list. Make sure you get the notifications about my videos. What else? Patreon, if you want to support the channel. And Berserkonaut on Indiegogo. It's still over there. You know, InDemand. You can get a copy. I'll send it to you tomorrow. See you guys later.